Have you ever found yourself scrolling through endless rows of data, trying to find that one matching piece of information? What happened if I told you there's a simple formula that you can use that will do all the heavy lifting in seconds? Today, in this video, I want to show you how to use VLOOKUP in Google Sheets. This is going to save you a lot of time. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. If you want to follow along with today's tutorial, I'll put a link down below to this spreadsheet so when you click on it, it's going to create your very own copy. We're going to start with the basics of VLOOKUP in Google Sheets, but then we'll progress with a few different examples to make sure you get a good handle on it. All these will be quick to do so you can start using this right away to save you time. Let's get started. Let's start with some basic examples of VLOOKUP here. I want it to look up an ice cream that I tell it to and give me back the corresponding price. So it will go down this side of the range, this list here, and find something like chocolate and return back that I know the price is going to be $203. So if I go over here to this spot, this cell, this is where I want to put my formula. And I'm going to start my formula with the equal sign, and then I can start typing my VLOOKUP. So if I type V, then L, you're going to find it come up right away. Let me walk you through the different steps of this VLOOKUP. Now, the first thing is going to be this search key. And I want it to look up chocolate. I could either cell reference it, and I'm going to show you an example of each, or actually just type in chocolate. But let's do it this way at first. So I'm going to go ahead, I have to give my quotation marks, and now I'm going to go ahead and type chocolate. And spelling matters, or else it won't find what it's looking for. So I can type my chocolate like this and my quotation marks. So that's the search key in this example. I place my comma. What's my range going to be? Well, the range is going to be the top part of the data set, which is vanilla, and the bottom here to this 210. So if I highlight these like this, notice it goes B4 to D13. That's my range that I have for this example. And then I can place another comma. The index is asking me in this case, what do I want it to return? What column? So I want it to return price. So these columns are going to be numbered from this ice cream flavor is number one, scoops remaining is number two, and price is number three. Then if I had another one after price, that would be number four. But so this is number three. I'm going to put the number three in right here. And then I'm going to go ahead, give it another comma. Notice it says is sorted. So by default, if I leave it blank and don't put anything in, it's going to be true. But I recommend that you choose false on this. And I'll show you a different example where you might want to use each of these as well. But I'm going to go ahead and type false for these first examples. And I'm going to go ahead and hit enter and return. So what did it do? It looked at this list on this side here and it found the chocolate. And it returned the index, the column I told it to return, was price at 203. Let's do one more quick example, and this time we're going to cell reference it, and this is what I would prefer to do. So if I go ahead and look, start my formula the same way, VLOOKUP, I start typing it in. What's my search key? This time I just have to click on the cell. So it's going to be G6. Whatever's going to be in that cell is what it's going to be looking up, the search index. I put my comma, the range is going to be the same, from B4 to D13, place my comma, my index, I still wanted to bring back price, so it's going to be number three, and put my comma, and I need to make sure that I say false. Well, recommended that you put false in here for an exact match. And then I can hit enter, and it brings me back 210. Here's butter pecan, 210. So now, if I was going to just type something else in, like this, notice, so strawberry, it went and found strawberry, $1.75, because since this was a cell reference, now I can quickly just change this. And like I said, this is the way I like to work is with the cell reference, but I wanted to make sure you knew that you could do both. I'll leave this spot right here for you to try on your own. Let me know if you get the correct answer down below in the comments. Let's move on to this example here, and this is a quick one. It's just going to be about changing that index column, and I'm going to go ahead and start my equal sign and put VLOOKUP, because rather than the price this time, I wanted to return how many scoops on the ice cream that I choose that are remaining. So in my search key, I'm going to cell reference, so I'm just going to click on G3 to cell reference it, place my comma in, my range is going to be from B4 to to D13, place another comma, and here's my index. So last time I was going to the third column, I'm going to put to the second column because I want the scoops root coming back this time. So I place 2, I'll place my other comma in here, and I'm going to do false again for the exact match. In my next example, I'll talk about the false versus the true on this point, but I'll put my enter, and then we have cookies and cream 7. If I look for cookies and cream 7, I can go at this time, change it to whatever I would like it to be, and it should change accordingly. So vanilla to 11. So making sure that you understand what that index does if I change that number. In this third example, I want to talk about approximate match and exact match. Now, this is the true and false part that I've already mentioned a bit. Let's go ahead and start with an approximate match, and that's leaving it to true and see what happens here. So I want this time to look up an ID and return that ice cream flavor. So 128 should be strawberry. If I go ahead and just start putting my VLOOKUP in again, just like I've done already, and the search key will self-reference it, comma, the range is going to be from here, A4 to D13, another comma. I wanted to bring back, what column is this? Well, this is number 2, so that's the index here. And if I leave it blank, if I don't put anything, it will default to true, or you can go ahead and write true like so. Now, the first thing that I want to mention is that you can see that this isn't going to be correct. 128 isn't butter pecan. But what you need to do, if you are using the true, which is the exact match, you need to make sure that these are placed in order, so sort. So if I go ahead and just highlight this area and go up to my data here, and I'm going to sort the range A to Z. Now notice, it's all in order. If I look at 128 now, 128 is strawberry. If I was going to go ahead and change this, let's say to 117 here, it should say chocolate, and it does. So it's important to make sure that that is part of it. Now, the other thing I want to mention is when you're using this approximate match, let's say if I put a number like 104, and notice there is no 104 here. So if I put 104 here, and hit return, it returns mint chocolate chipped. So it's looking at an approximate match. So 104 I put in, it had 105 or 103, but it picked mint chocolate chip. So if I was going to a number again, like 111, it's still gonna bring me back something, and you might not want that to have happen. So this is where the exact match, if I was gonna go over here and put my VLOOKUP, and I can go ahead and pick my search key, my range, my index, and this time I'm just gonna put it to false, like so. So now if I was gonna go ahead and put a certain number, so like I said, that doesn't even exist. So if it was gonna be 107, let's put in 107. Notice we get the NA. They couldn't find that value. So that's better than probably not having it exist. But let's say we don't want it to have NA like this, and we can put our own message, and I'm gonna show you how to do that now. If you're getting that error message, the NA one, and you want to replace it with a custom one, go ahead and do this. We need to add another function now. And so I'm going to go and put my equal sign in and then type if NA. So this is when the value is not NA, error, otherwise second argument. So we're going to tell it what we wanted to say. So I'm going to choose this one, but I need the VLOOKUP also. So I need to put the VLOOKUP nested inside of here. And I'm gonna go ahead and do my search key. So this is gonna be cotton candy. Here are this cell reference, the range, just like I showed you before. The index, what do I want it to have come back? It's gonna be price, so that's gonna be number 3 column. And I'm gonna put a comma, and I'm gonna keep this to false here. I'm gonna close this, put the comma in, and what do I want it to say? So I'm just going to give it a space, and I'll say inside quotation marks here, not, and I'll capitalize this, not found, just like this. And I need to close this. So this bracket and this bracket close, and these two close. So you always have to make sure that you have the open and the closed one. So I'm just going to hit enter. Notice cotton candy isn't on this list any, and I could have put any message that I wanted to, and I could go back to it, by double clicking and change this to something else if I wanted to. If I was going to choose, let's go ahead and write vanilla in here, we'll find the $1.50. And if I was going to say, let's say pencil for some reason, not found. So rather than having that NA, use the if NA function with the VLOOKUP to get your own custom message. Now I have a hack for you that I want to show you, and it's how you can use multiple criteria with VLOOKUP. So in this case, I'm going to put my VLOOKUP right here. I want it to be able to look up two different things. So it's going to look up gym and it's going to look up helper. And then I want it to bring back the department. And notice I even got a couple gyms to show you how it can break that down so it can give me back the correct department. But the first thing I got to do is add a helper column. And I'm just going to go ahead and add it right here. I'm just going to call this helper. And I'm going to go and combine these two columns on each of these names. So if I go and start my equal sign where I'm going to put my formula, I can go and click on the cell C4, use the ampersand sign or the and sign above the number 7, and then I can click on this one right here. So it shows me what it's going to look like. It just puts it all in one. So now I can just copy this down and I have all these new ones that I'm going to be using in my helper column. So now I'm ready to go ahead and do my VLOOKUP with multiple criteria. I'll put my equals in, start typing my VLOOKUP. What I want as my search key? Well, the first one's going to be gym. I'm going to use and what's the other one going to be? It's going to be helper. So I can put those two together like that. I'm going to use a comma. What's my range going to be? Well, it's going to be from this one to the bottom, so B4 to E14, comma. What do I want to have returned? So this is going to be the fourth column here where the department is. So I put my number 4, and I'm going to put this to false here. And I'm going to go ahead and close it up. So it brings me back, Jim Helpert is in sales. So you can see, here it is. It looked at those two different things. So if I was going to go and change this last name to Lee, look how it went through. This time it was matching the Jim Lee to the warehouse. So that's a cool feature. If you make that helper column, you can use multiple criteria with VLOOKUP. I hope this has given you a good understanding of how to use VLOOKUP in Google Sheets. Let me know what else you're looking to learn. If you want to learn more about Google Sheets, I have other videos as well, and I'll put the link down below in the description and up above in the card. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.